Hey people, John here from Fast Films, and today we are going through a 2007 romance comedy called Good Luck Chuck. The movie flips off at a sleepover between a group of teenagers. The premiering scene shows the group playing Truth or Dare. The bottle spins to two people and they enter a room. Little Charlie and his friend, Stu, discuss code words for activities in the bedroom. Charlie ends his discussion with Stu and sees one of the girls smiling back at him. Just then, the bottle spins to Jennifer, and since it's Stu's turn to pick, he and Jennifer go to the secret room and stare at each other. Charlie spins the bottle and it stops at the creepiest girl in their midst, Anisha. Terrified, Charlie follows Anisha to the secret room and tells her to stop staring at him. She moves a bit closer to Charlie and exposes herself. Charlie lets out a satisfying yell from inside the secret, which makes Stu proud he finally saw a girl. Anisha forces herself on Charlie and confesses her feelings to him. Charlie thanks her for feeling that way and gets harassed by her. Charlie later forces the door open and Anisha comes out and curses Charlie's love life. The next scene shows the present day. Charlie and Carol romances on the beach and Charlie enjoys it. Amidst their activity, Carol confesses to loving Charlie and Charlie just says, "That's nice." This infuriates Carol and she walks back to her car. Meanwhile, Charlie stares at the water. Charlie speaks to his friend, Stu, about his experience with Carol, and Stu advises Charlie to lie to Carol till he feels something real for her. They then discuss some more things when Natalie comes in and gives Stu a seductive smile. Just then, Reba, Charlie's assistant, comes in to call in Charlie to attend to his patients. Later that day, Charlie and Stu attend a wedding party and talk about some hot girls as they walk by. Stu follows a hottie as Charlie sights Carol and sits at another chair. The bride and groom stop the party and make an announcement. Just then, the bride proposes and makes a toast to Charlie for being her lucky charm. Everyone reluctantly accepts this toast and the party continues. At Charlie's table, some ladies recognize him and giggle about him. Charlie, who's clearly surprised, looks away and sees a beautiful damsel walk towards his table in slow motion. She eventually hits a waiter and spills some drinks on herself. Charlie offers her a napkin and she sits at his table. The lady introduces herself as Cam and Charlie tells her about his relationship with the bride. They discuss their occupations. Cam says she's a penguin caretaker and jokes a bit more with Charlie. Some moments later, Cam accidentally spills some wax on Charlie's pants. She apologizes and leaves the scene. Charlie sees his girlfriend Carol kissing another man in the distance and shrugs it off. The next day, Charlie arrives at his office and sees loads of ladies waiting for him. Later that day, Charlie visits Stu in his office. They both come down their building and see Carol shopping for a wedding dress. Apparently, she's getting married to the man she kissed during the wedding. Charlie gets home that night and listens to his messages. He's disappointed as all of them are from ladies trying to hook up with him. They believe they'd meet their true love after being with Charlie, as the rumor says. Back at Cam's workplace, she feeds a bunch of penguins when her brother named Joe brings some more food for the penguins. She throws a fish at him to punish him for being late. He catches it and launches it back at her. This makes her lose grip and fall in the water and chip a tooth. Charlie gets into his car with a lady who's desperate for true love. They eventually come closer that night. While at it, his emergency line rings and Cam tells him she needs his help on her chipped tooth. They set up an appointment that night for 20 minutes later. Charlie arrives at his office and fixes Cam's chipped tooth. They joke around with penguins and polar bears when Cam accidentally stabs Charlie. Charlie tells her to make it up to him by going out with him. Cam declines politely and leaves. Later on, Cam comes back to ask for Charlie's help with her car. After a series of accidents, Charlie ends up driving Cam home to get her spare car key. They get the key and drive back to her car. Cam apologizes for all the trouble and Charlie tries to invite her for dinner again. Still, she declines his offer and greets him goodnight. Charlie drives back to his house and sees his assistant Reba, who begs him to come close with her so she can find her true love. After much emotional talk, Charlie helps Reba out of her misery. He romanced her for the night. The next morning, Stu advises Charlie to take advantage of all the ladies who come to him for help while they play frisbee. Charlie listens to Stu and goes on a lustful spree with any woman that comes for his help. After a few weeks, Charlie explains how used he feels each time he does it with a woman. They discuss further when Charlie suddenly gets the urge to visit Cam at her workplace. Cam gives a presentation to visitors about penguins' gestation period when she cites Charlie. She cuts the speech short and goes to see Charlie. Charlie asks her why she doesn't want to go out with him. She's hesitant to tell him why, and Joe comes in to help her out. He spills the beans on all the nice things she'd been saying behind Charlie's back. Charlie playfully employs a little girl to ask Cam why she doesn't want to go out with him. Cam says it's because of the rumor around him. After much pressure from her admirer, she eventually decides to go out with him. Later that night, They're at their friendly date and they ask personal questions for themselves and talk majorly about penguins and sharks. Cam gets so excited from the meeting that she hits a pole just right after Charlie commends her for being a good kisser. Charlie steps on the floor and kisses her. They get giggly and run back. The next morning, Charlie is in Stu's office and they discuss his experience with Cam that night. He also tells Stu that he feels stupid for listening to him. Cam and Charlie's third date is at an airport parking lot. Charlie gifts Cam a band-aid for being so clumsy and she giggles at the thought as she knows she's very clumsy. They end their date in a carriage ride across town when Charlie smartly cajoles Cam into kissing him. They both arrive at Cam's place and things get really hot. They romantically get things to the next level. Just then, Charlie's emergency line rings. Turns out, Stu's on the other end of the line. Stu warns him not to come close with Cam. He supports his claim by saying all the women he took advantage of during his spree were already married. Charlie gets terrified and runs back home. Charlie and Stu are in a hotel when they decide to put Charlie's curse to the test. They see an obese woman and Charlie decides to come closer with her. The test was that if someone falls in love with her after he come close with the obese woman, then the curse was true and he'd be in trouble. Charlie ends up paying the fatty to take her out. He makes sure he drinks himself to stupor and then romance at night. After the horrible encounter, Charlie goes to the shower and waits for hopefully nothing to happen. Cam is back at work wondering why Charlie hasn't called her yet. Just then, Charlie calls her and she decides not to pick. Charlie sends her a voicemail telling her to talk to him online since he was sick and unable to meet her. Some scenes pass and we could see Charlie and Cam smiling and hurtling sweet things to each other. A woman tries to take advantage of Charlie again, but this time, he rejects her. They watch the same movies together. Stu is in the supermarket suspiciously buying a grapefruit. Charlie eventually fakes being married so the women don't follow him around. Charlie asks Stu to ask out the obese woman so she doesn't marry someone else. Later that night, Charlie and Cam are on a phone call. They joke around and Cam asks Charlie if he's avoiding her, but Charlie says no. Cam gets so turned on that she sends Charlie JPEGs of her in the bathtub. Stu's call comes in and he says he went out with the obese woman and that he doesn't feel like marrying her. Charlie leaves his house that instant and gets to Cam's house. The two get playful and make the best moments Charlie's ever had in a while. The next morning, Charlie wakes up first and goes to the kitchen. He turns on the TV and sees the fatty he slept with beside the love of her life on screen. He immediately calls Stu, who answers the call and says he never even asked her out for fear of falling in love with her. Charlie gets so depressed that he might lose Cam now that he's had amazing moments with her. However, Charlie takes things too far and gives her an all-you-can-eat buffet. Cam is surprised and suspicious of Charlie's hyperactivity that morning. Charlie says he's fine and he fumbles around for days. He later tries to fix a date for Wednesday as that was the day Cam would be seeing George. Later in the day, Cam enters her office to see the greatest surprise. Charlie decorates it with flowers and a "I miss you already" note. Just then, a band comes in to sing for her and give her a present. As they finish singing, Charlie pops out of the box and sings for his love. Cam gets a bit irritated that Charlie would invade her private space and sends him off. Disappointed, Charlie moves out of her office. Cam goes out from work to her car only to see it decorated again. Just then, Charlie appears out of her car and embarrasses Cam. Cam asks him to give her some space so she can think. Charlie gets disappointed again and leaves her. Stu impersonates Charlie while he's away. Upon returning to his office, Charlie tells Stu he needs his help. Meanwhile, Stu is already with a lady romancing her as he impersonates Charlie. Charlie proves his identity to the woman and she walks away. Charlie asks Stu to do some plastic surgery on his face so he can appear as the next guy to Cam. Stu says he can't help him out because he only deals with women's beauty. Stu advises Charlie to let her go and he says he can't. Charlie gets to Cam's workplace and he sees her and a guy hugging. He thinks the guy is George and attacks him. This embarrasses Cam as she tells Charlie to get away from her. Charlie still manages to tell her that he's scared of losing her. Cam later tells him it's over between them and Charlie eventually gets carted away by the cops. He stays out in the rain and Reba comes in to console him. She tells him to cheer up. Just as she's speaking with him, Charlie sees a garbage man drop a glass bottle. The bottle spins and this makes Charlie remember the curse Anisha placed on him the night their teenage group had that sleepover. Charlie and Stu drive back to their high school town when Cam takes care of a penguin who's sad over his sick mate. Her brother comes in and tells her to call Charlie. He also tells her that love is crazy and she should think beyond Charlie's behavior. Charlie arrives at Anisha's residence and knocks on her door. A little girl opens the door and Anisha comes in. Charlie begs her to lift the curse she placed on her. Charlie stands inappropriately before her. Anisha invites him in and tells him she doesn't remember what she did to him. Charlie kept begging her to help him out. However, Anisha tells him to let Cam go. Charlie gets back to the car and tells Stu to take him home. At home, he calls Howard to set up a meeting between him and Cam. Disappointed, Charlie stalks Cam for a while and gives up. The next scene shows Charlie playing games when Stu says he's getting married. He tells Charlie that he's marrying one of his patients with three melons. After joking around, the duo tells Charlie that Cam was leaving for Antarctica with Howard that day. Stu comes in and explains the situation to Charlie. Charlie catches on and gets inside his car and drives to the airport. At the airport, Charlie ends up buying two first-class tickets to get to the plane in time. He enters the first plane but doesn't find Cam. He hurries to the next one and sees Cam placing her luggage over her seat. Charlie lets his feelings out to Cam. Cam tells him she's getting back that Wednesday and shows Charlie Howard's wife. As the hostess tells them to buckle up, Charlie gift Cam a band-aid and leaves the plane. Cam calls Charlie back and rushes to come close with him. At that moment, Anisha sees her witch doll and breaks the curse she placed on Charlie. 1 year later, Charlie and Cam are seen in Antarctica. The movie ends when they try to come close and their tongues get stuck together.